Condoleezza Rice is, but as Sheila mentioned, no matter whether we know the person, whether we like the person, whether we hate the person, we have to look at the handwriting of this person. So it's, I actually prefer not to know who I am doing, so to speak, but I had to do her. So here we are. There isn't much, but what there is tells us a great deal. When we look at the gestalt, at the overall look of the writing, we find that it's beautifully placed on the paper. We look at the left and the right margins, and even the up and down, the spacing is just very beautiful. As I was writing when I was doing my notes, that the left and the right margins look like an invisible frame around her message. And she's of course very legible. That is a very important consideration when we look at her handwriting, because sometimes people are not that interested in communicating or being understood, and that can show in the handwriting. Well, I don't have to ask anyone, she's very anxious to be understood, and there's something very interesting that I will mention at the end, that I'll ask you whether you can tell what she's done to promote a specific idea. We talked about the connectors, the way she connects her letters. First of all, I don't think that there is a place, that there is a letter where she does not connect. Sometimes people have little spaces here and there, like people who are maybe, well, she's artistic actually, so I shouldn't go there. And the fact that she is totally connected means that she is basically methodical and likes to follow whatever she has to do in a very methodical way. That does not mean that she can't look outside the box because of the way she connects. There's a certain amount of, there's fluidity, and the rounded connectors, which we call garlands, also show a certain openness to other people. So there's a friendliness. And the spacing, of course, we're talking about form, movement, and space. It's very, very wonderful form level. Her signature, yeah, then the ending strokes on all the small letters are very nicely done. Rounded, not overdone. She wouldn't be effusive in any situation, but very well mannered and friendly again. The thing that struck me was, even though her signature is this, has the same style as the rest of the writing, and then we usually say, you see what you get, look at the size carefully and ask yourself, is her signature the same size as the word president?
Oh,
no, just a little smaller. So she knows her place. She knows her place. What I wanted to say, and I'll let you ask questions because I don't have that many answers. What I wanted to say is, it struck me that her wish to emphasize the three words, Iraq is sovereign. There's something very subtle that she has done with these three words. As a harpsichordist, I'm very impressed by it. I'm saying that because when you play the harpsichord, your dynamic range has to be very carefully planned on a very subtle manner. This reminds me of it, although she's a pianist, she's not a harpsichordist. But can anybody tell me whether they would agree with me, and also why? When they look at those three words, how she has lifted them out of the rest of the contents. It is subtle. Yeah.
Is it the placing of the period? How it's
the period? I hadn't even thought of that.
Oh.
Okay, number one. One likes to have more than one reason. Okay? Look at this, the one thing that Sheila says people cannot forge well. Look at the spacing. See, my cats know how to do this, but we got it. Yes, okay. The spacing between Iraq and is and sovereign. I know there is a bigger one here too, but the is definitely outstanding in terms of, it's very convincing. And the other thing is that if you look at the line, it is slightly higher than the word letter. It's done very subtly. Do you all see it? And the way she puts the I dot, I mean, she has a brain. Now, I assume, was this her too?
No.
We don't know.
No,
well,
that's Bush. She passed that, he put that on top.
Yeah,
of
okay,
that.
I figured. So does anyone have questions or comments?
Anita, are you sure of that?
Yes.
Does it look like his writing?
Yeah, it does. She passed it, they were sitting in a meeting, and they got the word, and she passed him the note, and that's what he wrote. We can check it, Google it up, but I remember seeing that.
It's funny, I was wondering, but then I looked at the bold T-bar.
Yeah, the L's are quite different. In letter, in left.
Well, I don't think it's she because she wouldn't do that. She wouldn't interfere with her own shape and elegance, so, And you actually saw it on a...
Yeah, I did, way back, years ago. And they were, from what I recall, they were sitting, they were having a conference or something, and the word came through, and she wrote that note and passed it to
him.
She got the word first.
Okay.
Passed it to him.
Because the thing is, you ask yourself when you're trying to understand the person after looking at their handwriting, would she be capable of this kind of a exaggerated, sign here, and it bends in a funny way? I mean, it just doesn't look like her. No. So does anybody have anything to add?
I was just wondering about the inconsistency with the letter I. Because in the first word, Iraq, and in the last one, Iraq, she has a different capital I.
Well, did I lose it?
No.
Okay. I would simply say that the first I is obviously very dramatic, and it took her more time, but she probably uses, my hunch is that she would use the second I more often, But she's trying to be dramatic, but that's a good point, because that is probably could be another reason, or another trait in saying those three words were the most important.
And also, her name really bothers me. I mean, it's just, it doesn't even look anything like her handwriting. Like her...
Let's talk about slant. Who can see a difference in the slant? We talk about vertical slant, going up and down, leftward slant, rightward, and of course there are many degrees. A little bit rightward, a lot rightward. She being very reserved, I think, is slightly rightward. However, what happens here when she gets to Condie? Smaller and vertical. No, don't.